Today we head out to Beverly Hills, California to marvel at the unique architectural spectacle known as the Spadena House, aka the Witch House. This is an absolutely beautiful Beverly Hills neighborhood with multi-million dollar homes. And the contrast between all the homes to the witch house, it's pretty outstanding. In the silent film era in 1921 in Culver City, the Witch House was built originally to serve as the office of the Eirvin Willat Film Studio. The Witch House remained on the Culver City property until 1926, which was then moved to its current location in Beverly Hills, California. Its intentionally whimsical, dilapidated storybook house design was the brainchild of Hollywood art director Harry Oliver. I really like the touch of the pumpkins surrounding the home here, along with the blackbirds. It's a really nice touch. In the 1920s, the Spadena family was the first family to purchase the 3,500 square feet home. The Spadena family owned the house for over 40 years. In the 1960s, a second family moved in to the Spadena house. They renovated the interior, but by the time the house came on the market again in 1997, it had fallen into disrepair. Due to the prime area the house sat in, making the property value skyrocket, and the house falling into disrepair, the house sat empty and unable to find a buyer. But thankfully, to a man by the name of Michael LeBeau, or LeBeau, sorry, I'm terrible with last names, but he purchased this house because he did not want to see it torn down. And actually, after he purchased the Spadena house back in 1998, he actually started getting threats. And the threats were, he better not tear down the house. But Michael didn't buy this house to tear it down. He bought it to improve on it. And that he did. He actually added some rooms to it, and he wanted to preserve this magnificent, sorry for the sun, he wanted to preserve this magnificent home, and he did just that. Now this home is actually a protected landmark here in Beverly Hills. I love all these pathways, and you got these doors in the back that lead to maybe a backyard or something. And I believe this is called an overgrown English garden. I think I read that somewhere. Now, don't hold me to that, but I believe that is what it is, with the bridge and the moat right in the front yard. So perfect. So perfect. Here's the bridge on the other side. You got a nice little waterfall. I can't get enough of this house. And it's really cool to think that this is from the silent era of film, of filmmaking. Just blows my mind. This is from across the street. And it's hard to believe that this hasn't been in too many movies. I believe the only movie that most people talk about is the movie Clueless. And it's in just one scene. You would think that it was used as a backdrop or something like that. More so. This is definitely a good time of the year to come by and see this. The fall weather, with all the leaves on the ground. Perfect time. Been waiting a long time for the sun to actually hit the Spadena House, aka the Witch House. And as you can see, some sun on the roof. There's not really much sun on the front there. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you like videos like this, you like stuff like the Spadena House, and you want more stuff like this, please check this video out over here. You'll like it just as much as you like this video, and I'll see you over there. See you guys later.